Gravity is a natural phenomenon by which all things with mass are brought toward one another. It has an infinite range, although its effects became increasingly weaker on farther objects. I used to think that anything could be explained by science, amazed by the idea that in every phenomenon, a ready-made formula from the book can be applied. But what seemed to be an encompassing field that is supposed to answer every question in life made my view myopic, and later had forced me to change my course. This all began with Pythagoras and his well-known theorem. My first memory of her.
Okay, so for example, in Pythagorean theorem, it can be applied using this situation. If you will add this will be equivalent to 25 units. These 25 units of the legs should be, according to the Pythagorean theorem, equivalent to the area of that hypotenuse. Since this is 5, if you were square 5, then that would be equivalent to 25. Mr. Lubsky, stand up and notice that you're not listening. Okay, what is Pythagorean theorem?
Pythagorean theorem is
a fundamental relation in the Euclidean geometry among the three sides of the right triangle. It states that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of the other two sides.
Very good, Mr. Gary. Ms. Kubowski, over.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's our lesson for today. Class dismissed. Ms. Kubowski, where are you going? Didn't I tell you to remain after class?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Kudowski, what's happening to you? Look at what you've done. You've done all bad and miserable things in my class. Look, you've failed most of my exams and also your quizzes. It's very easy. Why did you fail all of those? I'm giving a final exam, and if you fail this, I have no choice but to drop you in my class. I have no choice anymore.
Marie!
I did not know why I decided to help her. As if I was drawn to an unknowable force of her own creation. The only thing I knew is that I found myself approaching and talking to her, of which I can't help but imagine that if I was a star, she is a black hole. One day, she will lead me to my inevitable demise, but I am willing to risk it just to fill every moment with her. That was the start of our friendship.
So basically, gravity is a not accurately described by the general theory of relativity, which describes gravity not as a force, but a fundamental consequence of the an even distribution of mass or energy. So it is therefore a natural phenomenon that draws things with mass toward one another, like planets, stars, and galaxies.
Like people?
What do you mean?
I mean, as you have explained earlier, that when two objects are drawn together by a special force, it is called gravity. Is it same as people falling in love?
No, of course not. No, gravity is not relevant in the aspect of love. Because, according to popular scientists, gravitation should not be held responsible for people falling in love. The concepts of physics and chemistry to to a biological compost, such as love.
Oh, I'm sorry, Pierre. What is gravity then?
Gravity? It's just... Okay, so let's stop this nonsense discussion.
Maybe Einstein was wrong on what he said about gravity and love. Maybe if gravity exists within objects, so do within humans. Though it is said that the force of gravity decreases with increasing altitude, I find it strange to see that distance and altitude do not matter. For the more distant she is, the more that the attraction strengthens.
Pierre!
Yes?
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
I can't help but notice that what does the meaning of life entails?
There is no meaning at all. We have existed for 100 years ago, but the stars and galaxies have been there for billions of years. In the grand scheme of things, do you think that the universe purposely created us? Of course not. We're just one of the many tiny accidents of which a ball of energy have decided to explode itself like a Big Bang. So, how can you put a meaning to a meaningless universe who doesn't even know we exist?
I can't help but think about the first law of thermodynamics, that energy is created nor destroyed. That means that every part of us, every atom, every molecule, every particle that we embody will be a part of something else. Maybe we became a lion, or metamorphose as a butterfly, or become a big ball of fire that emits light billions and billions of years. And I would also like to think that maybe we were once a part of something else. Thousands of beautiful things that we helped to create. I hope we gave them a new life. A meaningful one, I hope.
Marie, there you are.
Hi Isaac, I would like you to introduce Pierre, the one I have to meet before.
My son.
Hi Pierre.
We keep seeing and meeting each other. However, we are far apart. I'm tethered on the depths of oblivion, and you're tethered beyond the void. Slowly, you are drifting, away from the universe, away from me. Unfortunately, I am still far, bounded with the physical laws I cannot defy. And the only thing that awaits me is the fatal kiss of gravity itself.
I have good news for you. I pass! It's all because of you. Thank you.
I decided to drift away and let the force of gravity overcome me. Because maybe in the parallel universe, she and I can have a chance together. For now, I am resigning to my fate and let it run the course of my life. Because just how everything ends with zero, I can move on. Someday, my feelings for her will be like, let's dance. It will shine brightly through its speed until it slowly vanishes.
Ha ha ha!